I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree. And a small cabin build there, of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honeybee. And live alone in the bee loud glade. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow. Dropping from the veils of morning to where the cricket sings. There, midnight's all a glimmer and noon a purple glow. And evening full of the linnet's wings. I will arise and go now. For always night and day I hear lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's gray, I hear it in the deep heart's core. Had I the heaven's embroidered cloths, inwrought with golden and silver light, the blue and the dim and the dark cloths of night and light and the half-light. I would spread the cloths under your feet, but I, being poor, have only my dreams. I have spread my dreams under your feet. Tread softly because you tread on my dreams.
Turning and turning in the widening gyre. The falcon cannot hear the falconer. Things fall apart. The center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosened upon the world. The blood-dimmed tide is loosened and everywhere. The ceremony of innocence is drowned. The best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity. Surely some revelation is at hand. Surely the second coming is at hand. The second coming. Hardly are those words out when a vast image out of Spiritus Mundi troubles my sight.
A waste of desert sand.
A shape with Mayan body in the head of a man. A gaze blank and pitiless as the sun. Is moving its slow thighs, while all about it, real shadows of the indignant desert birds. The darkness drops again, but now I know that 20 centuries of stony sleep were vexed a nightmare by a rocking cradle. And what rough beast, its hour come round at last, slouches towards Bethlehem to be born.